Hi there, and welcome to Cabinet of Resources. This is Vivero. In part one of this series, we looked at what OpenFAST is and how it can be used to design wind turbines. We also showed how they can actually download and run OpenFAST using the precompiled binaries. For those who are not conversant with the use of code, part one is sufficient for using the application. But for those who are more advanced, who want to make changes to the source code, or those who just want to learn how it is done, this part 2 is for you, because here we cover the methods and the prerequisites for running OpenFAST, or rather building OpenFAST using Visual Studio on Windows. This is the basic approach from the user documentation for OpenFAST, which has been linked in the previous video on the use of OpenFAST. So for those who are not conversant with code, you can go ahead with part 1. That is the basic way of using OpenFAST in order to edit to work on different blade dimensions and different sizes of a tower. You can actually do the editing in VS Code, that's Visual Studio Code, or any similar application, just to edit the text and run it again using your command prompt. Here, for building OpenFAST, those who make changes to the source code, there are several prerequisites that need to be done in order to be able to actually read the files on Visual Studio, as well as then build the solution, because some of these files are based on Fortran application. In order to build OpenFAST using Visual Studio, there are some prerequisites that need to be installed, because you need this framework in order to carry out the building of the files from the OpenFAST repository. In order to build OpenFAST for Windows on Visual Studio, there are two basic steps that need to be followed. Number one, the prerequisites need to be downloaded and installed and prepared. Number two, you can then download the resources from the GitHub repository for OpenFAST, and then you can compile and build it using Visual Studio. Step one is required because there are several framework and infrastructure required in the computer system which are not readily available as a basic feature. For example, you need Visual Studio, which is obtainable from a certain website, which the link has been provided in the description. That website provides the full steps of what needs to be done based on this recommendation in the user documentation for OpenFAST. Because there are certain files that will not open in Visual Studio if you do not have some certain framework installed on the system. So first of all, you need to have Visual Studio. For those who are students, it's preferable to get Visual Studio 2019 Community Edition. It's available for free. And the website to actually obtain it, this is the process to actually obtain Visual Studio online. So there are various versions. I'll say 2019 because the help file, which shows you how to follow all the four steps for the prerequisites, are based on 2019, and sometimes some applications work well with 2019. Secondly, you need to install Intel Fortran Compiler. The steps for this is available in this website, which I have linked in the description. It's much easier to follow all of the steps from the beginning to the end, which makes it easier, because if you do not follow these steps, it's not possible for you to actually build a solution, because Visual Studio, even if you install Visual Studio but skip number two step, you are going to realize that some files will not be readable and to tell you it's incompatible. So you need to follow all the steps in that instruction in that website in order to be able to complete the installation of both Visual Studio, Intel Fortran. With respect to the Git command prompt, you actually have this website where you can actually download it. Although the regular command prompt which we have on our system can also work, but it's possible to also download the Git command prompt. And lastly, for those who require it, you need to install Python and different frameworks in order for you to be able to install other libraries and classes within the Python and the system. So these are the steps that need to be followed in order to be able to build OpenFAST using Visual Studio on Windows. So once all of these prerequisites have been fully installed and activated, then it's now time to follow the process in step 2 for compiling OpenFAST using Visual Studio. So with compiling OpenFAST using Visual Studio, I have depicted how it is actually done following the different steps in the user documentation. So in this video, you see how it proceeds from the different files to when it's ultimately built, and then you see the other files that are generated after the build. So basically, this is for those who want to make some changes to the source code, and when they've done that and they build their solution, they have another exe file for OpenFAST, and that OpenFAST will be used the same way as you did for the precompiled binaries, but theirs is an updated version because they've made changes to the source code. But basically, everything is ultimately the same when it comes to how you run it and view the results of OpenFAST application.